Bill was always an all or nothing guy. There was no halfway for Bill. And wanting to experiment with mushrooms was to him a way of trying to like further his evolution as a person.
Just hearing about something was not good enough. Bill always wanted revelation to be firsthand.
Our family got this ranch, and it just ended up being a place where we could come and get away from everybody. A lot of our friends just like, oh, brother, you guys are just trying to get fucked up. And so Bill would just say, no, I mean, we really are trying to get somewhere else with this.
So we would go out and fast a little bit and prepare and then have this experience and see what happened. Well, some really amazing things happened. The world is one magical motherfucker. And if you take a certain amount of mushrooms, you're in a magical world. A lot of people have this thought when they take these, does anybody know about this? Because it's really like, it's like a secret. It's like this fundamental thing about the human brain, but no one knows about it and no one talks about it. There was one time in particular, the harmonic convergence.
It was basically this time when all the planets were to align in some alignment that only happens once every 10,000 years. I remember walking down this tunnel of light and feeling like Bill and I were walking into a spaceship. Bill was just asking, who are you and why are you here? And just basically being told that the boundaries of space and time are all in our minds and that we all are one, everything is one. We all are one, everything is one. I remember Bill just looking at me like, oh my God, can you believe that just happened? And at first I was like going, you know, oh, that was just something I thought of. And then Bill explained everything that I had just seen. And then the day went even further than that, where it was like tapping into all these other minds, and like thousands of them all at once. And I'm really skeptical. You know, I was ready to just say, okay, we're on drugs. But something about what happened on this day was different. It was significant and very tangible.
You know, this was accepted by human beings that you take substances to change your consciousness from the beginning of human history.
After that day, I think he really was like 100% sure that something did exist on the other side. It helped him go out there and become a lot more fearless. And part of his art was being able to broadcast cutting-edge ideas to the public.
We came here for the truth, right? That's all I want out of life, is the truth. Is that too much to ask for? You ever see a positive story about drugs on the news? Ever? Me either. Isn't that weird? The news is supposed to be objective. Same LSD story every time. We've all heard it. Young man takes acid, thinks he can fly, jumps out of a building. What a tragedy. What a dick, really, when you think about it. If he thought he could fly, why didn't he take off from the ground and check it out first? Why give acid a bad name? Because you're a moron, you know. I'd like to see a positive LSD story. Would that be newsworthy just once? Today, a young man on acid realized that all matter is merely energy condensed to a slower vibration, that we are all one consciousness going through itself subjectively. There's no such thing as death. Life is only a dream, and you're the imagination of yourselves. Here's Tom with the weather. Wow.